Okay. You can record me every now and then, but that's it. Welcome everybody to this fun time. Are you about ready to have some fun with me here on KGHSDenver.com? You don't have to be afraid with me because I'm going to have some fun with you talking about what you do. Sylvia, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you
at KGHSDenver.com. And streaming all over the world, if you're catching this camera, this is also being broadcast around the world. Also into London, Paris, France, Italy, wherever, and then into the Asian market, also with the great Rashid, who broadcast back from Bangkok, Thailand. So, that's all kinds of different shows. So, in the studio with me, Sylvia. Wow. I bet you weren't, you always said this to me too, and you said, you know, I didn't think I was going to go all the way.
Yeah.
Because we did have, Mrs. Cherry Creek in here.
Yeah,
the love doctor had her in here because they have to bring in there to push her.
Her
background and stuff. And you, what do you think? Tell us about yourself. Let's start when you were younger all the way to now. Did you ever think you'd be in pageants or doing anything like this?
No, pageantry was not my forte. I was more of a tomboy. Growing up, I ran track and dance. I've always watched Miss America and Miss USA on TV. But, you know, you have this vision of what Miss America or Miss whoever looks like. And although I'm older and I'm Mrs., when I was asked to do this, I was a little hesitant because I thought I don't look like a beauty pageant.
Why do you say that?
Oh, well, I guess.
Do you look in the mirror?
I do, but
well,
you know.
What's wrong?
I guess when most little girls look, you know, a person who is a beauty queen almost looks like Barbie.
No.
You know. And the long hair and the Barbie. So that was the vision. And then I thought to myself, and my husband was, the first one to say, why not? You know, when I was asked, why not? And then I let it marinate, and then I said, why not? You know, you don't have to have a certain look. And over the years, I have just become very comfortable and secure in who I am. And I've embraced my gray hair, and I've embraced my short hair.
And I keep saying, you say gray hair. That's not gray. I call it
my
cool.
Silver, my platinum hair.
Yeah, there we go. That sounds so good because it's chilly. Her hair is exotic. If you're here looking at what I see, and a lot of people probably tell her that about her hair. I love your hair. I know you get that. That's why I said, you really tell you that hair.
Yeah.
It just, it comes in with a like you say, a platinum with a black highlight. It's just really, really beautiful.
But I've empowered myself with just loving myself and being secure and owning who I am and, being secure with that. So, when I enter the pageant, I'm just me. And I represent those women who are secure with themselves, and you know they may not fit what society says is.
I've always wondered about this. It's society. Who is this person or this thing we call society?
I'd say that's media, that's print work. When you look in Hollywood, when you look at what's beautiful. I think that's a problem that our young women have today because there's a certain standard that everyone thinks
that it's supposed to be
beautiful. But beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. So you have to own your own beauty and feel comfortable where you are. You know, you may feel like my hair isn't long enough. If you want to buy hair, but if you don't want to buy hair, fine, you know. So I just say that you have to be comfortable with who you are and not try to be anyone else.
So I'm going to patch into you and I'm going to go on a close up. I'm going to pick myself out of the tell your audience about growing up, about where you ended up, married, children, anything like that. Give me at least 3 to 5 minutes and see how far you can go. And then I'll come back at you. I'm going to get a close-up shot of Sylvia Waller, right? Am I pronouncing your name?
Yeah.
Waller?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to patch into her so you can see what Sylvia looks like. And go ahead, Sylvia. It's all good.
Well, I'm from Louisiana. I'm from Louisiana originally, but I've was about 3 years old, so basically this is pretty much home. Grew up in East Denver, over in Park Hill. Went to school at George Washington High School. I didn't graduate there. My parents moved away to Westminster my junior year in high school, which I was very upset. Graduated from Pomona, but my lifetime friends are still from George Washington. And I've been to all of the reunions in 20, 30, and 40. So, moved away after graduation into Texas. Went to school at University of Texas at Arlington. Graduated there, got married, went to Atlanta. I have two children, Thomas Singleton and Brandon Singleton. And unfortunately, got divorced and moved back to Denver. I was a single parent for 12 years until I met my awesome husband, John Waller, and we merged two families together. We have two daughters, Elsie Waller and Brittany Waller, and we merged the two families. We've been married for 10 years. I was a insurance underwriter for commercial lines for about 20 years and got tired over the years and went through two layoffs and decided I was going to make a career change. So the career change that I made was into the beauty industry, which is what I've always loved. So right now I work as a freelance makeup artist and a medical esthetician. And in that, I meet a lot of women who struggle with who they look, what they look like. They're not happy with certain things. And I do understand that, you know, as you get older, things start to move. And they go south and they go places you don't want them to go. And I do understand that. So when I meet someone and I give them a consultation in skincare, I understand what you're talking about. You know, my face is tired, my face is dull. So I know how to direct them and the direction to direct them and what the solutions are. So I have a passion for uplifting women and encouraging women to embrace their beauty and to find their niche and to own it. So taking care of your skin and body inside and out, mind, body, and spirit, and just letting your inner self grow. That's my passion. So when I was asked to be a part of the pageant mantra is empowering, encouraging, and uplifting women. And I thought, well, that's what I already do.
Yeah.
So that's kind of what led me to get involved. And I chose the platform of Alzheimer's because my dad passed away in 2017 of dementia. And I'm an only child and a daddy's girl, and it was the most difficult thing I had to do ever to watch the person that you adore and you admire to deteriorate, and the roles have changed. I had become the parent and my dad had become the child. And because of my respect for my dad, I really had to choose my words on how to get him to do the things he needed to do without him feeling as though I'm disrespecting him. But I had to take on that role of, you know, being a parent and telling him what to do. And I would tell him, I'm not trying to do it, say to me, you're not the boss of me, and he'd get mad, and I would just say, Dad, I'm just trying to keep you safe. So,
and this is interesting, too, Sylvia, because just listening to you talk, and that's why I want you to speak, you know, your mind at 15
years.
There's portions of this that you are a serious woman.
Yeah.
So you must have some seriousness in you, because there's portions of you that you can tell you, you're a happy-go-lucky gal, but the other area that you're serious.
Yeah.
And that's what I like, you know. It's like, if you just joined us, Sylvia Wallace, Mrs. all around. It's USOA.
Right.
And so there's another pageant that goes out and out there, and so it's a little different.
Mm-hmm.
So that way I do want to make that clear. And she won the title. Mrs. Cherry Creek was running against it, wasn't she?
No, I believe Mrs. Cherry Creek is part of the USA system.
Oh, the USA. That's right. You,
yeah.
Because I was getting a mixed up.
And I believe there's three.
Yes.
There is the Miss Colorado America, Miss Colorado USA, and the USOA, Miss Colorado.
USA. Yeah. And that's really cool. Now, and it doesn't matter. They're not an age limit.
No, they're categories. For misses, it's 18 and up. You could be 18 and 99. So I happen to be the oldest one. So.
When you say, oh, you do not, and see, that's what they say a lot about the Latin women and the Black Americans. They hold their beauty for so long, they can be, 40, 50, 60 years old, and they still look like 30.
I sleep a lot.
sleeping is good for you, right?
Right.
So you get some beauty sleep. So that tells you a lot about me. I don't sleep.
I love to sleep.
Wake up. I'm holding me alone. You go do it. Do you really, how much hours a day do you get?
Probably about 7-8.
That's that good.
Yeah. That's good. Mm-hmm. I mean, when I sleep, I sleep. My husband says it does not take me long. I mean, if I lay my head down
for
2 seconds, I'm out. And I get good sleep. But I do believe in health and wellness. So I do take magnesium at night. And magnesium helps arthritis, so it does help with arthritis. It helps with calming you down to sleep.
Ooh, I didn't know
and
that.
If you think about it, when you go to the hospital, the first thing they do is put you up to a magnesium bag.
Yeah, really? I didn't know that.
Magnesium is good for anything.
Yeah, yeah. So I don't hurt that. I only heard when my wife beats me. But that's what happens.
Uh-huh.
And you get married and you get run over by the car and she's driving.
No.
Okay, how many women did you compete against?
I think there were 20 in the competition.
That's a lot to beat out.
But in my category, I believe there were 6.
Still, that's a lot of women.
Yes.
And what do you think made the judges pick you? I mean, you got the beauty already. I can see.
You know, every woman there was beautiful, strong, awesome. I mean, Amber Turner did a great job of handpicking all of the contestants. And the night before, I think it was that Saturday night, we all had a chance to just sit down and get to know one another. And everyone had a story.
Right.
And it was empowering, and it was also, uplifting just to get to know each individual on a different level. As opposed to competitor, we got to know each other on a different level. And I remember saying, no matter who wins, the organization was getting a beautiful gym.
Right.
Everyone, just
and you're gonna go to the nationals now, right?
Yes, I'm going to nationals, February 17th is the actual competition.
Where is that being held?
Las Vegas.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Have you been to Las Vegas before?
Oh, yeah. Las Vegas.
Really?
Yeah.
No, you'll never be in here. You'll never be in
Thailand. Really? You have to go.
Never. I've never been there. Everybody says that, but
it's the best place to be watch.
This is to be an apple. Watching people.
Watch people. You are entertained.
You think so? Is that what you guys go do?
We do that a lot.
You go sit down, get something to eat, watch everything. What shows have you saw?
We've seen The Lion King. If you haven't had a chance to see it, it was phenomenal. Michael Jackson, This Is It.
Mm-hmm.
That one is also phenomenal. I would like to see Diana Ross. She'll be there. I believe she's only there.
I heard that. I would like to get to see
I saw J-Lo. J-Lo was awesome. And she was incredible. Her yeah. energy level is just.
Every guy in the world.
And she's gorgeous.
Yeah.
She's gorgeous.
You know, I have always said this. I think, I don't know why, I always thought that she stepped into Selena.
Yeah, well, she did her movie, yeah.
And I always said she stepped into her shoes and took off.
Yes, she did.
Yeah,
you're right.
She took off the whole image.
Because she was acting for a while, and she was. And when you thought of Selena, she was.
I think she was one of the girls on.
She was a fly girl.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. I remember seeing her.
Yes, yeah, so you're answering all my questions for me.
I remember seeing her on.
I didn't take my magnesium today, so I can't remember them. And I'm hurting. And I was talking to the love doctor earlier. This is really interesting. I'm like, you forget my name. You're still in the studio already. I was playing with her. But it was really interesting. Now, you have two children?
Mm-hmm. I have four.
Four children?
Two boys and two girls.
Oh my gosh. And
two boys biological and two girls.
Any children? Grandchildren?
No, not yet.
No. Yeah. Are they married?
They're not married, so.
Well, yeah, no, D-Rose.
That's okay. They're not married, so my thing is you have kids when you're able to take care of them because
that's really good.
That's nothing. I'm not. I want to be grandma, not mom.
So. That happens a lot. Here they try to leave the girl. You see, I've got two granddaughters myself. I don't mind hanging with them, but after that.
I want to enjoy grandma. I want to enjoy being grandma.
But if you look at Sylvia in here in the studio, she doesn't look like even close to any grandma. She doesn't look like even with, she looks very good. That's why I probably should have won the pageant because they seem the same thing. You know, but it was a carry yourself. Well, did you sing or anything in the pageant?
Yeah. I would have been
You know, singing. Did they
There's no
recite
talent.
Something or did you?
No, there was no talent. Basically, in this competition, it's swimwear, lingerie. What am I thinking?
You know what she's thinking?
Evening gown.
Mr. Waller. She's going to be wearing some lingerie for Valentine's Day. I got it out. It's up close and personal. She just let it loose.
Evening gown.
You can't clean. So. You can't clean that one up. It's live. We're live. Sorry. Can't clean it up.
That's a slip there. Yeah.
That's a Freudian slip, Mr. Waller.
Swimsuit.
You know what you're getting for Valentine's Day.
Swimsuit.
I'll keep it going.
Gown.
We'll have to find something.
I see. But yeah, and then we had the on-stage questions, and because we had our first interview, so our interviews were with five judges, so we had five judges, and we talked to them individually, and had a chance to get to know, for them to get to know us, and I guess my story resonated with them.
It's a great story, too, you know, that they couldn't bury your father. There's a lot of people who do this, you know, some people take it on and man, it can be kind of trying on you.
It does.
Sometimes you almost want to just throw in the towel and say, I give, get some professional training, I give, right?
Well, you're right. Statistics show that 30% of caregivers are depressed.
Mm-hmm.
And I do remember going
through. Did you go through a lot of depression?
I went through depression, I went through anger, and it
And then this is your number one.
Yeah, it was just me. My mom died 13 years ago.
Oh, did she live?
Yeah, so it was just
was
my
it
dad.
A disease or something?
Yes, she had. She had breast cancer.
Yeah, hurts a lot of people.
And the two of them were in high school sweethearts, so that was tough for them. And, you know, we struggled with that whole ordeal of missing her.
That's always okay, especially if you're really close to your wife. Close for a long time, and then you have Sylvia as your daughter, and she, you know, everybody's close, even though it's three.
Listen,
Hispanic families are like 80 of us.
Well, you know, the ironic thing is my dad came from a family of 11, and my mom came from a family of 10, and they only had one. So they only had one because she couldn't.
Yeah.
So they always teased him, you know.
The guy always gets a tease. The woman gets nothing. You know? Women get away with everything, even the beauty. And I've always asked this question most of the time. All the women wear makeup and they wear these beauty things and all this stuff. And then, you think men should?
She'd wear makeup?
Yeah, makeup and all of that.
I don't think so either.
They're just handsome as hell, right?
Yeah, I don't. Yeah. I mean, even for women, I mean, working in the makeup industry, I personally, the older you get, the less you should wear. I am just a minimalist anyway, for as far as makeup is concerned. If you're doing something special, then I would say, you know, dazzled up. But every day,
dazzled up with that makeup.
But yeah, not too much. Every day. I see. Every day is just a little too much.
Yeah.
You know, I just think that your skin should breathe and, you know, skin.
Yeah, I think like this too.
Makeup
about women.
Should look like skin. So people shouldn't say, ooh, your makeup looks good. They should say your skin looks good.
Some chicks put on so much makeup, it's like, yeah.
It's fake.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So the beauty, you don't have to like the beauty.
It's like they got out of control with their 64 crayon
bottle. Oh, my.
Some of them put stuff on their face.
Yeah.
It's like, come on, girls. Are you listening to this? Minimal. Your beauty is your beauty roll and put on the negligee.
You are not going to let that go.
No. I'm just... Well, if you were on the Love Doctor show, he would be after it.
Oh, I'm sure.
Because they're gonna. He does a lot of cool things. That's what he does. He plays love songs between the sheep kind of songs. Those cool songs. That, you know, love songs. Mm-hmm. He's got a show coming up with for Valentine's Day. So he's always looking for something. And then we've got several people here. Who have the things. We've got a lot of people. Who have 17 shows. Mm-hmm. 17 shows upcoming. Good. We have help shows. And for substance abuse, we have all kinds of things. We have Spanish language.
Oh, okay.
So we carry the Spanish language that's good for you. We got the show here on Sunday.
Okay.
And tomorrow she's going to have Lisa Calderon, who's running for mayor of the city of Denver. Now, some of the women that you run up against, are they all variable?
They were, you know, it was different ages.
Different ages. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we had this, which is 18 to 25.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then we have a Ms., which is anyone 25 and older cannot move.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So you could be, if I weren't married, I'd be a Ms.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the Mrs. is 18 and
Which is pretty cool, you know. Like, you got all these variables. Now, when you kept going, what were you thinking? Give us your thoughts on that. Your heart beating?
My heart was beating, but I mean, from day one, I always felt like I'm a spiritual person. You know? I always felt like God has a plan for me. So, His picture was bigger than that, and my picture or my thoughts were, okay, I'm going to do this, and we'll see how far it goes. But his plan is not bigger. So, you know, as I progressed, I was
thinking, is this
good? I kept, exactly. It was very surreal to me. Now I felt like I probably will place. But I wasn't sure if I would actually win. I wouldn't say that I didn't think I would win. I was just, I always said it could go any way. It could go either way.
Was your husband there to support you?
Yes,
he was. Did he take pictures? It was a front row.
Yeah. Well, they didn't allow cameras inside, but I did get pictures. I had some friends that didn't really allow that.
That'll make any sense why you can't take pictures.
I didn't understand that, but they wouldn't let anyone inside family members take pictures or video. But I did have a friend that got pictures inside.
Oh.
She was sitting in the back and she was sitting in the back and was out of the camera sight. And so she, because she was in the dark, she was able to get some pretty good shots.
Now your gowns, who provided your gowns for you?
Peaches Boutique out of No, I was gonna have someone make it and then at the last minute she couldn't do it and I was scrambling.
Oh, Sylvia, I bet you're like,
I was scrambling, I was in a panic, and my husband said, well, just go online, and so I started Googling, and I saw Peaches Boutique.
There's some really cute outfits.
They have, they have such a wide array of dresses.
What color did you wear?
My first dress was purple.
Oh, yeah, you know that's majestic. Yes, I was going to tell you.
Yeah. And it's also...
Oh, it is purple.
Okay. And that's also the Alzheimer's as well.
Is it really? I didn't know that.
This time I'm wearing black.
Ooh.
I when I thought of colors, I thought what goes with my hair. So certain colors won't go well with my hair on the stage. So
actually, yes, your hair is nice. It looks sharp as that.
So I figured white or silver I would go with this time. Yeah. My first dress was purple and silver, so I had it done.
Did you have to have it
altered? Yes. So the wonderful people at wedding alterations, wedding dress alterations,
and got it in time.
In our back, I got it in time.
Oh my gosh, I bet you.
And they have my new dress, and they're going to be getting it back to me. Yes, I mean, I got the dress back on the 8th, and I had to leave on the 11th. Yeah, it was close.
And besides your husband, any other support?
Oh, my kids were there.
Were they really?
And I had some friends that go there.
Now, tell me this. When you kept going to the end, what were you thinking at that point?
This is happening.
It's really like, it was really good to be there. And then when they announced it,
I was totally shocked.
Did you cry?
Oh, I cried.
You cried a river.
I cried a river. Because I was so humbled and so.
And was your family jumping up and yelling?
Yeah. Yeah.
My kids just took it live, you know? All sneaking and stuff.
Although my friend did. So that's how I got my pictures. She
awesome. That is so cool.
Did it.
Well, you got to. I don't know why. I mean, come on, Project Company.
it was a surreal experience. Something that I will never forget.
And it's really nice to have her here, Sylvia Waller, of winning Mrs. Colorado of pageant and going to the Nationals now. And the Nationals are going to be held in Las Vegas, Nevada. That's going to be great to go out there and check that out because you're used to it. So you know where to stay and everything.
I
love the people watching. They're really good.
You'll love it.
You can just sit there and just have your lunch and say, look at this. Wow.
You will see sheets everything under the sun.
The movie stars. Everything.
People who think they are.
There's a lot of those running around, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, is there any last thing you'd like to say to the audience that's watching and listening right now? Going to the Nationals, anything about how do you feel?
Right now, I'm very grateful and humbled. I'm going to represent the state of Colorado. I'm honored, and you just have no idea how grateful and honored I am to be representing the state. It's not something that I would have thought would have happened to me.
And sitting here with Sylvia, it's such a humbling experience. I mean, just listening to her, you can feel her energy, you can feel her aura of how good she does feel, you know. And so sometimes you get some in here, and I have a few in here, you can tell that they're not quite attuned or focused. Mm-hmm. And you can tell you're totally focused and attuned, and you feel good about what you're doing.
On a mission. On a mission.
So wear that negligee for you.
Oh my gosh.
I always look for the opening for that. Once I got my teeth into something, I won't let go. It's all for fun here on KUHS. You're listening to the Block Party, and I'm sorry if you missed it. We're going to be toning out right now. And right here with Sylvia Waller. And for now, yeah, we've got to have a little bit of fun with this and see what's going on here on KUHSDenver.com. And if you'd like to say goodbye, I'm going to say goodbye for now. What do you think?
Oh, yes, I would like to say, one thing I would like to say is we are having a people's choice vote. So I would like the viewers out there to vote for Mrs. Colorado. All the proceeds, I believe it's $2 a vote, and all the proceeds will go towards the Alzheimer's Association. So whoever wins the People's Choice Award, the proceeds will go towards their charity.
And that's the one.
And my charity is Alzheimer's Association. So the website is UnitedStatesOfAmericaPageant.com, and you can click on People's Choice and then vote.
Isn't that nice? Sylvia Waller, I'm glad you got to join me here on the block party. We're going to get back to some good music and enjoy what we have going on here. And for now, I've enjoyed having you here and bringing you on set and doing all this fun stuff that we always do here at KUHSDenver.com. I want to pick a love song for you. Let's see if I can find one here. And, this will go out to all the people who are going to be celebrating Valentine's Day. And so you always want to do something real special with your lady, and you want to treat her like a lady.
I love that song.
So, for now, I'll see y'all later, okay?